probably the least darkest in here.
You're a black guy. It's so bad today.
Oh, you're recording? Oops.
What's up?
Have arrived! Check out the university! Right there! Hongik University! This is it! Kevin wants to find this handmade ring place. This is the one, I think. So we're gonna go check it out. But it's such nice weather. Oh my goodness. And we took a bus here. No problem at all.
No problemo. We are totally integrated now into Korean culture.
Yeah.
Not quite.
Found our chicken place. Is it open? I don't know. But it's called Kyuchang. Oh yeah, there's someone inside. Let's go. It's here. Let's dig in, guys. And guess what? Thomas is doing a live Instagram. Is anyone watching? Oh, someone's joining. Our wings are here. It looks so good! We got the
Dai
honey one!
Dai coffee.
Yum! How is it?
It's so good, it's so crispy. But it's not heavy on the batter, it's like super duper light. But it has a lot of crisp. And the flavor? Amazing. Crazy kick. This is so so good. This is the garlic one. And it smells really garlicky, so hopefully we're okay tonight.
The Kyuchang sauce, garlic soy sauce.
So come here in Hongdae. Tell them we sent you. They won't know who we are, but just say it anyways.
Alright guys, so lunch is done and now we're at the ring shop because Kevin wants to make a special couple's ring for him and his girlfriend. So that's what it looks like. You can actually like do your own thing here with all the tools and like carve writings on there. So it's quite neat actually. Shopping at Hongdae, and now we are in.
We are in Dongdae again in the Gwangjang Market. So we are gonna go get some food because yesterday we really enjoyed the bibimbap that we got. So we wanna come back for that again and maybe try out some of the fresh seafood that they have.
Look at us!
Kimchi galore.
All the stores are here. So much goodies!
Wow.
It's so busy.
to eat them?
Yeah, little crabs. See the. What do you want, Thomas?
I'm sorry?
What do you want?
I'm craving kimbap, but I want to find you some soup. Something, because you like soup, right?
Actually, is that all the stores here are owned by women, females, and that's quite cool. Like,
it's true.
Yeah.
There's no male cooks.
Yeah, no male cooks in the stores. Like,
woman power.
Yeah, hardworking ladies.
They got a hustle here. It's pretty crazy. Like, it's a lot of competition.
And last time we came for lunch, right? That means they've been working all day.
Yeah.
Because it's the same ladies that served us yesterday, and they're still here, and it's already over 6 p.m.
We should go back to the same ladies and eat the food there, because it's pretty good. But I'm pretty sure like it's pretty much the same everywhere. I noticed that the menu and everything's the same everywhere.
And the price is the same, so that's good.
You
won't get scammed.
Yeah, because I mean, if they screwed up the prices, then I think one vendor would be mad at the other for kind of like
stealing customers and making competition.
So it's a big market, but really the food's all the same around. Unless you go to like the independent restaurants where there's tons. Like all the vendors along the side, I mean along the middle are the same, but along the side you're going to notice a lot of restaurants. Those are more, I guess I'm sure there's a lot of hidden spots here. And I hear that the yuke here is really good, which is a raw beef with, it's like the,
raw beef,
think of it as
oil and raw egg.
Yeah. Not like carpaccio. What's yuke? What's that word for it? Tartar. Beef tartar.
Yeah,
so. Yeah, beef tartar. I think it's basically the Korean beef tartar. So. Let's go eat.
We got our yuke, which is raw means basically like Korean beef tartar. And yes, it is completely raw, so for a lot of you, it's kind of like, eh. But it's super delicious, and at this market, it is famous. It is famous here, and so totally worth trying. So I recommend that everyone who does come, give it a go if you have the stomach for it. If you don't, totally understandable. And yes, it is cow meat. Usually it's probably better paired with soju, but I just want to try it just for what it is, so.
Just add the sauce on top or dip it?
I think we might dip that.
Yeah?
Yeah, so I think we just break the egg and then we just dip it.
Break the yolk.
Break the yolk and then just mix it. Oh, and underneath is
hair
slices.
Hair?
It's kind of sweet.
A little bit. It's perfect. The meat itself is super tender. The sauce has a little bit of salt in it. It has that saltiness. And when you have it with the pear, which is sweet, it's like shabam combo. It's amazing.
Kevin's gonna try.
Let's see how this is.
That's good, right?
That's good. Salty, nutty flavor, right?
Yeah.
Kind of? Yeah.
Sesame, I think.
Yeah.
What is up, y'all? We are now headed out of the Gwangjang Market. We are headed to go shopping in Dongdaemun, which is famous for a lot of nice clothing for especially guys who want to shop in Korea. I hear that's a very good area to go to. Instead, the only downside is that you need to haggle lots. You gotta bargain like crazy, and you gotta know how to bargain. If you don't like to get hassled by those people, probably not the right place for you. I mean, you could go there and just accept the price that they give you, but it's usually marked up quite a bit, and you can usually get it down to, I would say,
50%, 60%, but don't expect that everywhere. For those of you who are used to going to like countries like Thailand and stuff where you can really get the price low, it's not really like that here in Korea. You can't get it as low, but you will get a pretty good deal. So again, yeah, it really depends where you go. Not everyone's gonna give you 50% off, but I just say on average. What happened yesterday was I went to find a sweater, and the place that I went to, it's like all the same clothes at each shop, just maybe a little bit different pricing, or the people might want to give you different pricing. So the first guy offered me 34,000 won for the shirt, and I was like, no way, I'm not paying that. So I actually lowballed and I went 15 because I was trying to just meet halfway between that. And then they're like, no, best price I can give you is 28, take it or leave it. And I was like, okay, I'll try something else. So then I go to another place, exact same shirt or sweater. The guy offered me 35 or 34, so pretty much the same. And then I said no. He's like, okay, are you gonna pay cash? I'm like, yeah, I'll pay cash. He's like, okay, I'll give it to you for 20. So he marked it down like 14-15 thousand, which is like 14-15 bucks. So I was like, oh, okay, well, in that case, let's go down to 15. And then eventually he went down to 15. So it just really depends. Just shop around and don't say yes, even though you're super excited to see the first item. If anything, just be like, oh, let me think about it, and walk away, and then eventually you can go back. But never show true crazy eagerness to buy anything, because once they catch on to that, they know that they got you and they will sell you
That's
at the price that they want
to
sell it.
To try it on so they can yeah. see your reaction.
So, you know, just kind of be smart. Don't be overly ambitious and eager. But at the same time, just be respectful and don't, you know, try to like lowball the heck out of them too bad, you know? Because at the end of the day, everyone's got to earn something. So if you got to pay like an extra, what, $2 or $3, just pay it, in my opinion. Ain't that right, Kevin?
Yeah. It also helps to have like another buddy that you can like
yeah,
tag team
into. Yeah, the funny story is that yesterday I really wanted that sweater because I looked at multiple vendors, and then eventually I went to one of them and I was like, okay, I just gotta get it because I just gotta get it. So eventually I was like, okay, let's try to get it for the price I wanted, which is 15, because I thought that the worth of that sweater was no more than 15 bucks. So then I was like, all right, Kevin, tactics here. So I like tried it on and I looked at it and I was like, I knew inside, I was like, okay, I'm gonna buy it right now, right here. But then I'm like, Kevin, pretend that you don't like it. And then Kevin like just kind of gives me the face like, dude, I don't like it, shook his head. And then the guy was kind of like, oh crap. And then I was like, okay.
Make sure the guy sees.
Yeah, so he saw that and he's like, oh, okay, like his buddy doesn't like it, so maybe I won't make the sale. Then I was like, okay, well, it's not that great of a sweater, but if you give it to me for 15, I'll take it. And he's like, 16! I'm like, then I like saw like a little thread on my shirt coming loose. I'm like, no. You see this? 15. He's like, all right, 15. So he gave it to me for 15. So it's kind of, for me, I kind of find it entertaining somewhat to go there and interact with the locals and try to bargain and stuff. But again, not everyone's cup of tea, so if you're not into that, there are other areas to shop, of course, all over the city. It's Seoul. It's known for its fashion, so you can find a lot of stuff anywhere. Anyways, let's go shopping.
Many hours later, why is your shirt different?
I spilled juice on my phone.
No, he went shopping and he bought a new shirt and he's wearing it already.
It's cold today.
Did you get a good deal?
Yeah. Pretty good. Almost half off. So, yeah.
How much does that cost? The sweater.
About $13.
Sweater material. $13.
Yeah, not bad.
And where are we going now?
Piggy bank.
Because that's all you do in Seoul. You eat and shop and eat and shop.
And look. And poop. And sleep and poop and walk. We made it to our barbecue tonight. So excited.
Here's the menu. English. Japanese and Chinese. Pretty good. I think we are gonna get some pork belly and beef ribs. Here's what the restaurant looks like.
We're next door to Piggy Bank. But whatever, Korean barbecue is still good, so we'll take it.
What's that?
Got some makgeolli.
Makgeolli.
Some rice. Rice wine.
Thomas is not a drinker at all.